We are using and creating data all the time. Today, more than ever, data is in every aspect of our lives. But this data is more than numbers and figures. Our governments collect huge amounts of data to help make decisions that directly impact people's rights. To healthcare, education, clean water and sanitation, adequate housing, food security, work, and access to land. Data is often presented as objective or neutral, but it is inherently political. Gathering data requires making choices about who and what should be counted and how data is used. Usually, those who face injustices, discrimination, and impoverishment are not involved in these decisions. And in that way, they are invisibilized and excluded. Data exclusion occurs in many ways. In the choices about who and what is counted, when governments exclude some groups, for example, people living in informal settlements, from official data collection, when they discredit data as biased because it was collected by those experiencing injustices, while relying on commercial data gathered by powerful technology companies, when they don't gather data about some issues, such as women's unpaid labor or the impacts of climate change on certain communities, or when they don't ensure data reflects patterns of inequalities that exist among us. Exclusion also happens in the choices about how data is used. When governments and companies conceal important information that people need to participate in decisions that affect them, or they use personal data to profile, exclude, or punish people through the use of algorithms and automated systems. Data exclusion is a barrier for millions of people to access their rights. The good news is that increasingly, communities are developing skills to measure what matters to them and are demanding that governments produce and make accessible high-quality and inclusive data. Learn more about how we can make our human rights count.